Let's give ourselves some practice adding mixed numbers. So let's say I want to add 2, let me write it this way. Let's say I want to add 2 and 4/7 plus 3 and 2/7. 3 and 2/7. I encourage you to pause this video and try to think about what this is going to be. Well, there's a couple of ways that you could tackle it. One way you could say, well, let me just add the non-fraction parts. You could say that 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. And then you could say that 4/7 plus 2/7 is equal to, well, 4/7 plus 2/7 is going to be equal to 6/7. Anyway, wait, how did I do that? How did I just only add the fraction parts or add the whole parts? But the way I did that is because 2 and 4/7 is the same thing as 2 plus 4/7. 2 and 4/7, same thing as 2 plus 4/7. And then plus 3 and 2/7, the same thing as 3 plus 2/7. So all I did over here, 2 and 4/7 plus 3 and 2/7 is 2 plus 4/7 plus 3 plus 2/7. And you could swap the order in how this happens. So you could take, you could just switch the order and say this is going to be 2 plus 3 plus 4/7 plus 2/7. And what we just figured out was that 2 plus 3 is equal to 5 right over here, and that 4/7 plus 2/7 is equal to 6/7, just like that. Now let's do a more interesting example. Let's say that I have 3 and 3/5 plus 5 and 4/5. Now what is this going to be equal to? Well, if you do the same technique, if you add the 3 plus the 5, you're going to get 8. And then if you add the 3/5 plus 4/5, you would get 7/5. So you get 8 and 7/5. And this wouldn't be wrong. This is 8 and 7/5 if you add these two things together. But it's a little bit strange here because 7/5 is bigger than a whole. So to get a better sense of what number is really being represented here, I want to rewrite this. So 8 and 7/5, this is the same thing as 8 plus, instead of 7/5, we could say this is the same thing as 5/5, which is a whole, plus 2/5. Now why is that interesting? Because 5/5, notice 5/5 plus 2/5, that's 7/5 right over there. Or you can consider 5/5 to be 1. So this is 8 plus 1, which is 9 and 2/5. 9 and 2/5. So all I did here, I added it the same way that I did the first problem a few seconds ago. But when I realized that this fraction part is greater than 1, I separated it into 1 and then a fraction that is less than 1. And that whole I was able to add to the 8 to get to 9. And then I would have 2/5 left over. 8 and 7/5, because 5/5 is a whole, is the same thing as 9 and 2/5. So if I wanted to write this in kind of a, I guess, a clearer way, I would say this is 9 and 2/5. 3 and 3/5 plus 5 and 4/5 is 9 and 2/5. And once again, you say, wait, 3 plus 5 is only 8. How did I get a 9? Well, that's because 3/5 plus 4/5 is greater than 1.